going to talk down some big concepts about bowing. These apply to anybody, whether they're beginning stages of their playing or more advanced stages of their playing. So first off, we need to think about getting the violin up on your shoulder. It's important to have it at sort of a 45 degree angle. If it's too far over here, your bow is going to have a hard time getting to it. If it's too far in front, everything's going to be cramped. So have it at about a 45 degree angle to your body, that is. When I put my bow on the string like this, I get what we think about as square position. So this is one, here's another, third side, the fourth side of the square is invisible, but you can imagine it. The way we move our bow arm in square position is to open and close the hinge of our elbow like this. Okay, the goal of our bowing is to keep the stick parallel to the bridge. So the stick here and the bridge here have to be parallel. If you have your bow straight and parallel and your violin's at the right angle and you open and close your elbow, you should keep a steady contact point with your bow. To get closer to the frog here, you have to bend your elbow further, and then at a certain point, your shoulder has to move forward too. I call this the little triangle, okay? So from the little triangle to the down bow, we have to let the shoulder come back and then open up the arm to square, the elbow to square position. Okay, we can open the elbow some more. If I want to get to the tip, depending on how long your arm is, I don't have to reach out very far. If you have kind of short arms, you might have to reach out further. I have to push my bow that way. I call that out. This is in. So I have to push my bow out just a little bit. No, it's not very much for me. And even if you have pretty short arms, it's not going to be really drastic. So then on the up bow, I'm going to let it come in a little bit. And then I'm going to close the hinge of my elbow. Back to square position. I can close the hinge of my elbow some more. About here, I need to start letting my shoulder come forward, or the upper arm come forward from my shoulder. Notice that at no time during the stroke does this shoulder get raised. It's when I'm at the frog, I'm not doing that. I'm just moving this way. It's good to realize that we have these great ball and socket joints that can move independent of this motion. Also on this side, we can move our arms around to accommodate different strings without that motion. If I could tell you one thing as a violinist to avoid on a big level, it's any kind of that motion. If you find out that you're feeling tense or that you're sore, check to see if you're doing that. Here's another thing about, now that we know how to draw a straight bow, we need to think about how to change strings. And this is where the ball and socket joint comes in handy. If I'm at my square position, this is a great exercise for you. I'm going to kind of flap my wing like a bird. Notice that I'm not hunching my shoulder. I'm just flapping my wing like this. Okay. The whole arm moves up and down. The bow and the upper arm should be roughly on the same plane. And if they're not exactly on the same plane, it's better if the elbow is a bit lower than a bit too high. A bit too high is going to wreck your tone. Okay, so just let your arm be relaxed. The bow follows your arm up and down. For string crossings, it's easiest in the middle of the bow. You can do it at the frog. In fact, we have to do it at the frog, but the easiest place is the middle. It's at the tip. You have to move your arm more. So we have basically two kinds of bowing that we do. One is bowing all on one string. So I can bow on my E string. I can raise my arm just a little from the ball and socket joint of my shoulder. I raise my arm up to the A string. Raise my arm to the D string. Raise my arm to the G string. And all of that is done with that same motion. And those were all separate. One string for one bow. If I want a slurred string crossing, meaning that one bow stroke covers two different strings, the same rules apply, and I will cover those in the next video. Thanks for watching.